In order to write these numbers in scientific notation, they need to be in the form of A times 10 raised to the power of B, where A, called the significand or mantissa, is greater than or equal to 1 and less than 10. So to rewrite 15,600,000 in scientific notation, we first need to determine where we'd have to place the decimal in order for A to satisfy this condition. Right now, the decimal point is here, and in order to satisfy this condition for A, the decimal point would have to be placed here. Now, by counting the number of decimal places from here to here, we can determine the exponent on 10. So we have to move it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 places to the left in order to satisfy the requirement for the value of A. Therefore, written in scientific notation, we would have 1.56 times 10 to, we move the decimal place 7 places to the left, so our exponent will be positive 7. Now, sometimes it's difficult to remember whether this exponent should be positive or negative, and here's an easy way to remember. If we start with a large number, like we did here, 15,600,000, in order for this to equal a large number, this exponent here will have to be positive. Multiplying by a positive power of 10 will make 1.56 larger. Now let's convert a small number to scientific notation. Again, the first step is to determine where the decimal point would have to be in order to satisfy this condition here for A. So the decimal point would have to move from here all the way to here to make 8.72. Now let's count how many decimal places we have to move from here to here. It would be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Which means in scientific notation, this would be equal to 8.72 times 10 to the, because we move the decimal to the right, it's going to be negative 5. Again, to me, moving right and left gets confusing as to whether the exponent should be positive or negative. If you can just remember that the original number was very small, then multiplying 8.72 by a negative power of 10 is going to make a very small number like we started with.